Welcome to Gurukul.com. In this video, we'll talk about how to create issue type using Jira REST API. Whenever we are working with Jira cloud versions and we wanted to create too many issue types, probably where we can use REST API call. Generally, it will make our life easy to create any issue types without wasting much time, and this is much quicker. So we'll show you in detail how we can generate using Postman. So for this example, I'm going to cover with the Postman. Here we will create a new request, and here we'll select post method. How we can create endpoints? So for generating an endpoints, I will use here the domain name which we are using for our project. Next is basic authentications. I've already covered the basic authentication setups. If you don't know how to do that, feel free to refer my initial videos of REST API. I have already covered in detail, so I will include the URL in description tab so that it will be easy for you to refer. Now, this is done in terms of authorizations. After that, we'll just write REST /API, and which API versions we are using, I will specify the version number. And next, here we have to write issue types. So issue type, that's it. Next, our endpoint is ready. We need body to be prepared. So for preparing the body contained, here we'll use raw, and instead of text we'll use JSON format. Now, whenever we are adding any request, we need to have two mandatory requirements. One, we will need Jira admin access as well as authorization method, which we will use it as API token. Once this is done, we are good to go ahead with the body contained. So first of all, let's understand what is issue types. Whenever we can have a look inside our Jira instance, here you will see issue types are generated. Whenever we click on create, you will see these are the issue types listed. But if I wanted to create a new issue type, probably either I can use UI or I will use REST API. So with the help of REST API, we can create issues directly without accessing our UI portal. So what we need to add here, first is curly brace. After that, I will add in double code descriptions. So here descriptions, and after that we'll add colon, and next will be the value. So this is my field, and next I'm going to use value. So this is created by REST API. Now we'll add semicolon here, hit enter, and then we'll add name. So in this case, my name will be that colon, and in double quotes, I'll specify the name. Now, before proceeding, I wanted to show you here, we don't have that name exist, which I'm going to use here. Here, we don't have feature available. So I will create feature from this tab. So here I will add feature, and then again add semicolon. After that, I will add next field as type. So type, post that code, and within this I'll specify standard because I wanted to create this as a standard. Now that's it, we are done. We can also use some other parameters or field, but as of now, as a mandatory requirements, whichever fields is required, I'm creating it here. I wanted to show you the manual process as well. Whenever you are creating it manually, you have to just click on add issue types, specify the name, descriptions, and the type. So here, either you can use standard issue types or subtasks. Based on your requirements, you can specify this. ID will also work for this one, but as of now, I'm going ahead with this name itself. Now, once we are done with everything, hit send and should type. Maybe I will add this forward slash and click send. Again, it's showing the error. Let me change this standard and hit this. Now, because of this parameter, this is case sensitive. That's the reason we have to add in the lowercase. And here we have this ID created. So it means feature is added successfully. If I want to see this, I have to just refresh this page. And from here, I can see this feature is created. As of now, we have not assigned anywhere. That's the reason it was showing in gray color and even less schemes. Now, once we are done, we also got the ID as well. Now, if I wanted to just see how many issue types we have, just remember this issue ID. Post that, I will show you how we can delete it as well. Further actions I wanted to perform as get method. So whenever you want to just have a look about issue types, how many issue types we have under this, you can easily see it with get method. Simply we have to change method and endpoints will remain same. So here you can see everything is available and we can also see the last one which is created by us. So here wherever is the features, we can see that 307 projects. This is epic. I wanted to just have a look about the last one which we have created. This is subtask. This is with subtask. Again, this is related to test. This is subtask 209316 test plan. Next is subtask again. This is again a subtask 17 story. Next is task. This is again task. This is a feature. So this is our ID which we have created successfully. At any point of time, I wanted to delete this feature or issue types. From here, straight away, I will use ID at the end of endpoint. Change the method to delete instead of get or post. I have to just specify delete and hit send. This will delete the recently created features or issue types under our Jira instance. Because I've added here ID, that's the reason it will delete the particular item. Now, if you want to have a look, just refresh it from the UI and you will see the features will be deleted successfully without any delay. So that's how we can create, get or extract the detail or extract the issue type detail as well as delete any issue types from our Jira cloud instance. That's all from this video. If you wanted to learn more about REST API, feel free to refer my complete REST API playlist. And if you wanted to understand Jira for project managers and scrum masters, feel free to refer my complete Jira playlist. If you have any topic in your mind which you want me to cover in my further sessions, feel free to add the topic name. I will definitely cover that topic in my further sessions based on the demands. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. Feel free to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.